Hi children, good morning. Welcome to our next class. This is also from crop production and management. And before videos, we have completed manuring, preparation of soil, the steps involved in preparation of soil like ploughing, tilling and manuring we have completed, right? So the next process in agricultural practice is the next step is what is that and what we are going to learn today. You are going to tell me now. Okay. So I'll show you something. You tell me what I am holding and what purpose these are useful. Okay. See this and tell me children what are this? These are seeds, right? These are seeds. So what should I do these seeds to get a baby plant? I am having seeds. What I need to do these seeds to get a baby plant or sapling. To get a sapling or baby plant, what should I do? To get a sapling, I need to sow these seeds. What I have to do? I should sow the seeds in the soil. So you got an idea what topic we are going to discuss today? That's sowing. In agricultural practices, the second step we are going to discuss, that is sowing. Sowing means keeping the seeds in the soil and till it get germinates and to get a baby plant, and this sapling will grow and give a healthy crop, right? Sowing is one of the important step in agri practice. And what we have to keep in mind before sowing? Before sowing, we need to select the healthy seeds. Select healthy seeds, that is very important in sowing process. Selection of healthy seeds. Then how to do? How can we find out which are healthy seeds and which are not? To understand this, we'll do one activity now. For this, take a beaker and fill this beaker with half of water and take handful of seeds. Handful of seeds you take and keep in this water. Stir it and observe after some time. Can you see? Some seeds are floating on the water, whereas some seeds occupied the place at bottom. Bottom of the beaker they reached, and some seeds are still floating on the water. What's the reason? Among these two, which are healthy seeds and which are not healthy seeds? The seeds which are floating on water are unhealthy seeds. How can we say that? Before saying that, you need to understand the parts of a seed. This already you learnt in your lower classes. A seed is having a coat. When you see the groundnut seed, the seed which is there above, this is known as seed coat. And inside the seed coat, you just break into two pieces. This groundnut break into two pieces. You can see two white color parts. Two white parts are visible. These are cotyledons. And in between two cotyledons, the embryo is present. Are you able to see? These are all available in your home. Not only the groundnuts, any type of seeds you take and perform this activity, and you also identify the parts of a seed. So now we observe the parts of a seed. It's having a seed coat. and two white color cotyledons it have. These cotyledons are nothing but nutritive value they contain. They are the nutrients. They supply the nutrients, stored food. The cotyledon is nothing but the stored food. They supply the food for growing embryo. An embryo is hidden in between these two cotyledons. That means the embryo is hidden inside the seed. So whenever the seed need to get germinate, when it's coming out, the cotyledons will supply food to the growing embryo. Okay. So now in our activity, some seeds are floating on water. That means I said those are not healthy seeds. Why they are not healthy seeds means this cotyledon part is not completely developed or maybe eaten by some insects. By storing time, we'll store the seeds for next season. Farmers will store the seeds. So when they are storing, some insects may eat this cotyledon part. That means they are unfilled grains. No cotyledon or nutritive part is missing in them. That's why they are light in weight and floating on the water. And the seeds which have the completely filled nutrients, they'll take up the place at the bottom of the beaker. So this is a process to select the healthy seeds before sowing. And even farmers should see, they need to choose the clean and healthy seeds to get a healthy crop. And before sowing the seeds, they have to clean the seeds by using some chemicals like fungicides. They need to dip these seeds in this fungicides, and after cleaning only, they need to go for sowing the seeds. So this is the process of selecting healthy seeds. And then we'll see the methods of sowing. Is there any method for sowing? Are the farmers following any scientific approaches for sowing the seeds? We'll see. Before sowing, before plowing, and farmers definitely will approach to the agricultural scientist for soil analysis. They'll test the soil and which type of nutrient is lacking in that particular soil. According to that, they will advise the farmer to grow what type of crop they need to grow, they will advise. So now we are going to discuss about methods of sowing. We'll read about methods of sowing. The methods of sowing depends upon the crop they are growing and the size of the seeds. The size of the seeds, based on that they'll choose the method, and the type of crop what they are going to grow in their field. For example, if we see broadcasting method, in this method, farmers will stand in the middle of the field and they just throw the seeds in the open field in one direction. Okay, so that method is known as broadcasting method. Is it a advisable method? Is there any disadvantage with this method? Can you guess? What happens when farmers are just throwing the seeds in the open field? Yes, there is a chance for some of the seeds will fall at one place. Some places many seeds may fall. Some places the seeds will not fall at all. Where the seeds are more, there it takes a lot of competition between the seeds. What competition? Is any running race goes on? Not like that. they'll compete for sunlight, water and the nutrients from the soil. It will become crowded for the seeds, and some seeds may not germinate and they cannot stand in that competition, and it will be waste for the farmers. For this all will be a loss for the farmers. So then, it's not an advisable practice, but even though some farmers till the date we are doing this process for sowing seeds. And the next method is planting. In planting method, the seeds can manually planted in the soil. If the seed size is big, we can sow that seed in the soil manually. So like our potato, mango, cotton, soya bean, these all seeds are sown in this method. That method is planting method. And then third method is, some seeds are very small. So what the farmers will do for that, they will sow those seeds in a prepared beds. They'll prepare some beds before, and they sow that seeds in the prepared beds. The beds are known as nurseries. So this process, this method is known as transplantation method. Transplantation method. So what type of seeds they are using here? Very small size seeds, like our tomato seeds, our rice, chilies, brinjal. These all the seeds are very small in size. So first they sow in a prepared bed called as nursery. After growing in the nursery, after germination, they'll grow into sapling. To a certain height when they grow, then they will pluck, they'll take out all these saplings to the main field. There, they will sow the saplings again by giving proper distance. So this process is known as transplantation process. So these are the different methods farmers are using to sow the seeds. Now we will see, do the farmers need any precautions, or as they wish they can sow the seeds? Yes, they need to take some precautions while sowing the seeds. What precautions are needed while sowing the seeds, we'll see now. The first thing is, they should see at a proper depth. The seed should fall in a proper depth of the soil. The depth is important while sowing the seeds. If the seed is placed in too depth of the soil, that may not respire. The seed cannot do the respiration process and it may die. And one more thing, after germination, when it is sending its shoot outside, it cannot able to come up to the upper layer. So there are two disadvantages when the seed goes to too depth in the soil. At the same time, if the seeds are superficially means only at the top level of the soil. When it is superficially placed, there is a chance the birds may fly, they come and eat that seeds. There is a damage with seeds when the seeds are superficially sown. So the farmer should see at a proper depth, then they need to sow the seeds. And after sowing, they have to cover their seeds with soil. Otherwise, again the same birds or insects may come and eat those seeds, whatever they are sowing. And there should be proper place between one seed to the other seed, so that seeds may not go for competition with each other. Proper sunlight, water and nutrient availability will be for each and every seed, and they can germinate, they can give healthy crop to the farmers. So proper distance is needed, proper distance is compulsory, the depth of the sowing seed is compulsory, farmers has to take care, and even the soil should have plenty of nutrients. That yesterday's class we discussed, manure to be supplied before sowing, so that whenever the soil is very fertile, a healthy crop farmers get and their yielding will increase. And now we will see what are the tools we are using in sowing. Are the farmers using any tools? Yes, there are agri tools, different agri tools they are using for sowing the seeds. One is traditional tool that is from long back, ancient times farmers are following this. This tool is funnel. The structure of funnel will be like this, as it is like our funnel which we use in our chemistry lab, and it is connected with pipes. Strong pipes will be, they'll have sharp edges, and this funnel is tied to a plow, and when the plow is dragged by the bullocks, this funnel also move along with plow, and the seeds to be placed in the funnel, and these seeds are slowly fall into these tubes and they pours into the soil, and it with equal distances, because the farm, the bullocks will be going on moving, so there won't be any crowded area. The seeds will fall with equal distances. So it's an traditional tool, but even though useful tool for sowing the seeds. And the next tool is seed drill. Our seed drill, it's a modern agricultural tool, and it can save the time and labor also. Farmers need not to spend more amount for labor. With a machine easily they can sow the seeds. So this structure of the seed drill will be like this. It will have sharp funnels, and it can be used by tying with a tractor, and here in these holes the seeds will drop into the soil. Whenever that drill, seed drill is moving forward through these holes, the seeds can get dropped into the soil, and they are having equal distances. And same advantages how we are getting through the funnel, here also same advantages, overcrowding won't be there, and seeds can get sufficient amount of sunlight, water and this all. So these are the tools we are using for sowing the seeds. Okay children, so our today's topic we completed, what's the meaning of sowing and how to select the healthy seeds, and what are the methods we are following to sow the seeds, like broadcasting, planting and transplantation we discussed, and the tools what we are using for sowing we discussed, those are funnel and seed drill, and what are the precautions to be taken while sowing the seeds we discussed. Right children, so you draw these two tools in your notebook neatly and color them. and you also write what are the advantages, what are the precautions to be taken while sowing the seeds. This is your assignment, children. One is draw the different tools used in sowing process. And the next question is, what are the precautions to be taken while sowing the seeds? Okay? In tomorrow's class, we'll discuss about the irrigation and the tools used in irrigation, the methods of different methods of irrigation. We are going to discuss, children. Thank you.